Okay, this is going to be the second video about factoring a second-degree polynomial. So let's pick up where we left off with the first video. You remember I gave an example like this, x plus 3 times x plus 2, to show how we get a second-degree polynomial. And we're going to keep referring to that as we factor more of them. Okay, so here's the next problem. I want to factor a squared plus 2a minus 35. So as before, I'm going to start out. I'll put in my two sets of parentheses since I know that what I want is basically two binomials. Looking at the first term, I've got a squared. So that must have come about when this was foiled together by multiplying an a times an a. So I would have an a here and an a here. The next step is to look at my signs. The second sign here is negative. Well, the way you get a negative sign when you multiply, in other words, we multiplied a number that was here, a constant, and a constant that was here. And when it multiplied together, it gave us a negative. Well, if you multiply two numbers together and you end up with a negative, one number must have been negative and one number must have been positive. So let's bear that in mind. And then we'll have to do something with the fact that we have a positive 2 over here. So let's think about what numbers we can multiply to get 35. And then we'll deal with the negative. Okay, so 35 could be 1 times 35. And 35 could be, let's see, any number that ends in 5 is a multiple of 5. So remembering that, 35 is 5 times 7. And these are the two ways we can factor 35. I can't divide it by 2, I can't divide it by 3 or 4 or anything else. I can only divide it by these numbers. So one of these numbers is positive, one of these numbers is negative, whichever pair I use. So I know I'm going to have, well, I don't know which ones I'm going to have. If one's positive, one's negative, then what that means is one is getting subtracted from the other. So let's think about this. If I subtract 1 from 35, I get 34. If I subtract 35 from 1, I get a negative 34. So neither of these is any good. If I subtract 5 from 7, I'll get a 2. In fact, if I have a negative 5, let's make a little room. A negative 5 and a positive 7, looks like that's what I'm looking for, I'll get a positive 2. And you remember this positive 2 came about from combining the two middle terms, which is the same as saying the coefficient of this negative, the coefficient, the 2, is going to be what happens when you combine the last terms here. So what that basically means is I want a negative 5 and a positive 7. Now, something I didn't mention before, but I hope you realize, it doesn't matter which order I do these in. In other words, I can write a minus 5 times a plus 7 or a plus 7 times a minus 5. That would just be a matter of commuting these two binomials. Okay, so let's multiply this back out and make sure that we're right. So I've got a times a is a squared. A times 7 will give me a positive 7a. A times negative 5 will give me a negative 5a, and negative 5 times 7 is negative 35. I want to combine my two middle terms, a squared plus 7 minus 5 is plus 2a, and my minus 35. That's where I began. So this factorization checks out. Okay? One more, a little bit scarier, but it shouldn't be that hard once we begin to understand it. So let's see. I've got 3x squared minus 12x minus 36. Now remember, in the beginning of the first video, I said that we were only going to be dealing with second-degree polynomials where the coefficient of the first term is a 1. So now it looks like I lied to you, but not exactly. Let's just look at this, not thinking about making it into two binomials, but just can I factor out some common factor? Well, I can't factor any x's out of this because there's no x over here, but I've got a 3, a 12, and a 36, and all of those are divisible by 3. So I can start by factoring this polynomial into 3 times x squared, and then I'm factoring a 3 out of this negative 12. Well, 3 divided into negative 12 is negative 4, so it's negative 4x. I'm factoring a 3 out of this negative 36, and 3 into negative 36 is negative 12. So now what I've got is a first degree polynomial, x squared minus 4x minus 12, where the first coefficient is a 1, and I'm just multiplying that whole thing by 3. So what that means is, as I go about solving this, I have to just remember to keep that 3 as one of the factors. And now I'm going to figure out what to do with this polynomial right here. Well, I've got an x squared, so that's going to be x and an x. I've got a negative 12, so both of my signs are different. One's positive, one's negative. Let's see how we can make 12. Well, 12 is 1 times 12. 12 is 2 times 6. 12 is 3 times 4. Let me fix that too. One of these numbers is going to be positive, one of the numbers will be negative. So let's just see what would happen. If I have a 1 and a 12 and I subtract one from the other, I'm going to get an 11. It'll either be a positive 11 or a negative 11. So those are not going to work. If I have a 2 and a 6, and one is positive and one is negative, so in other words, I'm subtracting one from the other, then I'll get a 4, either a positive or a negative. So it looks like this is the pair I want, the 2 and the 6. Then it's just a matter of figuring out which one is which. Well, there's a really simple way to do it. Look at the number in the middle. The number in the middle is negative. So I want to put that sign, that negative sign, in front of the bigger number. So I'm going to put it in front of the negative 6, in front of the 6, make it negative 6. I'll put a positive 2 here. Let's see if we can work backwards and check this answer. So I'm going to have 3 times, let's FOIL this out, x times x is x squared. X times negative 6 is negative 6x. I've got a 2 times x is positive 2x. And I've got a 2 times negative 6 is negative 12. I'll combine the like terms in the middle. I'll get x squared. Negative 6 plus 2x is negative 4x minus 12. And then I'll distribute this 3. So that's going to give me 3x squared. 3 times negative 4 is negative 12, so that's negative 12x. 3 times negative 12 is negative 36. Let's just check, and it looks like everything checks out. So this factorization is correct. Okay, let's just review this quickly. First of all, if your lead coefficient, if your first coefficient is not a 1, see if you can factor a common numerical factor out of each of the terms. After that, write your parentheses out, because you're going to have two binomials. Take whatever variable you have here, like x squared or a squared, put one of each in each of these spots. Look at the signs. The signs are going to tell you whether you have two positives, two negatives, or one of each. Find the factors for this term over here, this constant term. Find the factors and see which factors add up to give you the term in the middle. Okay, that's it. I'm running out of time. I'll try to make sure there's plenty of practice problems so you can work on these some more. Take care. See you next time.